Oh hey, welcome back to another week at Bedros Station. Thanks again for tuning in. This week I'm going to combine two of my ultimate loves. So you're clearly aware one of my first loves is technology, and the reason being is because of my other love, which some of you may well be very well aware of, is my love for Star Trek. I grew up with it, my sister used to watch it a lot and then she got me into it, and today I want to talk about the influences of Star Trek on modern day technology. Yeah, but in order to do that, I need to appropriately dress for the occasion. So, there goes my street cred, if I had any. But yeah, I've been a massive Star Trek fan for quite a while. You can call me a Trekkie. I've only been to one convention, but I've met a few famous people from Star Trek. But it's about Star Trek's influence on modern day technology. And you're gonna see how much of a geek I really am. So unless you've been living underneath a rock or an asteroid for the last 60 years, Star Trek was created by Gene Roddenberry in 1966. Most famously, it was around in the 60s, and then it was made into movies, then it was re-released in the 80s and 90s, and then it was rebooted again within the last few years on Netflix and Prime Video. What it's basically about is exploration through space, visiting new planets and new aliens and conflicts and things like that. It's all super fun. There's a lot of morality behind each episode. It's super fascinating to watch, but what is also fascinating is the technologies that were predicted back in the 60s and have now had an influence on today. Maybe not as basic as the automatic doors that they featured in the 60s, which was invented around the same time as well, using different features such as foot pads that you step on in order to open the doors automatically. Now we have motion sensors and things like that. But that, I'm not counting that one. Let's get into the nitty gritty. But it is boiling in this, so I'm gonna change back. Ooh, that's better. They must have had really strong air conditioning on these starships. So first of all, I'm going to talk about pads. Now, pad was featured throughout Star Trek as, and it's defined as a personal access data device. They began in the original series in the 60s as much bigger pads, a pen or a stylus, where they could access data from the main computer on whatever starship they're on. And then it evolved in the 80s and 90s into handheld pads. Now, this might sound familiar because today what we have are tablets and iPads, which we use every day. I haven't got one to hand, but they all use the same touchscreen functionality. And who would have thought that Star Trek would have predicted that from all the way back in the 60s? Communicators. Now, iconically, you would have seen Captain Kirk use what looked like a flip phone, flips it open and speaks to whoever from long distances. That obviously developed into the flip phone that you saw in the 90s and early 2000s. There was the Razor phone, even the Matrix, Neo using a flip phone as well. And of course, Adele, she uses a flip phone too. So that kind of device in the 60s was even improved upon towards the 80s and 90s, where they incorporated it into the comm badge, the badge that's on most people's chests, so that they just tap it and then they communicate to whoever they want to, which we can do nowadays with just our iPhones. And there are a few wearable devices that you can use for communications today as well. So even though a communication device like the one that flips in the 60s evolved into a badge, it's the same thing in the real world as well, that flip phones, they eventually died out in order for a tablet type phone. Universal translators. Now obviously on these shows, it's an American show, so it's a bit weird that everyone is speaking English. So they introduced the universal translator into the script. This means that whoever is speaking in whatever language would be heard by the recipient speaking in English. That's why everyone speaks English, crazy enough. We actually have that functionality today. We have Google Translate and other competitors where if you speak into it, it will recognize what language you're speaking, and then you can select which output language you want and it will instantly translate that. So we've got that too. U-Screen conference. So on the show, whenever they wanted to communicate with anyone, they would have a big, massive view screen where they could communicate with other people, not just seeing all sorts of anomalies in space, but also communication. And they had that on pads, they had that on big view screens, which is exactly what we have today. We have communications through Zoom every day now, but it's exactly the same situation where we're able to communicate while seeing everyone's faces, and probably a little bit too much as well. Replicators.
This device.
What does it do?
That's a standard food replicator. Computer, one slice of New York cheesecake. This is an old Earth delicacy.
How do I know you're not trying to poison me?
Oh, please.
So, throughout the entire Star Trek franchise, they used replicators in order to produce food, ask for what they want, and it would be synthesized, and the food would just come out. They would also use it to make equipment as well. And most recently, that has come to life with 3D printing. You can 3D print any kind of object in different kinds of materials, and most recently, it's become possible to 3D print food as well, but as I believe, it's not very tasty. The International Space Station, they had a 3D printer installed in 2014 so that they could 3D print their tools up there as well. Tricorders. Now, since the 60s, there's been various versions of tricorders. You had the big one, which Spock or McCoy would be using to look for biological or geological data, and it's evolved throughout the decades within Star Trek. Now, certain functions of tricorders have been developed throughout the years within science, being able to test things like distance and biometric data and things like that. We can measure distance and we can measure the weather and humidity. Even our watches can take our heartbeats, our blood oxygen levels as well. So that's starting to evolve a lot more rapidly in the past 10 years. Hyposprays.
It's good to be back.
Are they recovering?
Slowly, but yes.
This was used frequently throughout the show for the doctors to inject medicine into people without using needles. It was just a simple device that they touch on the skin. Now, the reason why hyposprays were brought in, interestingly enough, in the 60s, was that NBC had a policy where they could not televise drugs being injected through syringes. So the creators of Star Trek, they came up with the invention of the hypospray to avoid needles whatsoever. But in the modern world, MIT have recently created a device that delivers medication in a similar fashion. It uses a jet inside that is the size of a mosquito's proboscis. It can deliver medication at up to 340 meters per second. That's super fast, and apparently you don't feel anything. So I don't know why we're not using this yet. That's how I want my vaccine delivered. Voice interface.
Computer, increase ambient temperature by 2 degrees centigrade. And increase relative humidity by 10%.
Computer, reset environmental controls to standard.
From the 60s in Star Trek, various characters within the show would ask the computer many different types of questions, and the computer was able to respond all through voice command. At the time, it was something that you couldn't even imagine you could do. However, now we have all sorts of voice assistants, so we have the same thing now. Like, for example, hey Siri, what's the weather today?
It's currently raining in 9 degrees. Expect cloudy skies starting early in the morning, then rain tonight.
Okay.
Today's high will be 11 degrees, and the low will be 8.
Okay. She's a bit persistent, but it does the same thing. But not control a starship, though. Portable memory. Now, in the 60s, what you would see them use are these portable discs. They look like just pieces of cardboard, really, that they slot into the computers to show information from the databanks. And that developed in the real world as well with USB drives. But within the show, it didn't really get past the 60s because from the 80s onwards, computers were more sophisticated. So all the information was located within their main computer and in the modern world as well. Not many people use USB drives anymore because we store all our data in the cloud. So even the advancement past portable memory has developed in the real world, not just on the show as well. Holodecks.
Computer, load Mariner program all new to Olympic training facility.
You might want to back up a bit.
Wow, this is a really detailed program.
Now, the most awesome invention throughout the whole of Star Trek was a simulator on a starship, which is the size of a whole room. You go in, you say what you want, and it will recreate a holographic environment that you can not only see, but you can walk through and touch. It was amazing. I've had several dreams, I've had several nightmares about it as well. And that has become a reality in the modern world as well, through virtual reality, which has become more sophisticated nowadays. You've got things like the Oculus Quest and Oculus Rift and other virtual reality headsets that you can use. And I've got an Oculus Quest. It is amazing. Like, the first time I put it on, it really was like a holodeck. You can walk around, bump into things in the real world, but there's all sorts of games. It's really incredible. I definitely recommend it. An evolved society.
So there are privileged few who serve on these ships, living in luxury and wanting for nothing. But what about everybody else? What about the poor? You ignore them.
Poverty was eliminated on Earth a long time ago, and a lot of other things disappeared with it. Hopelessness, despair, cruelty.
Young lady, I come from a time when men achieved power and wealth by standing on the backs of the poor, where prejudice and intolerance are commonplace and power is an end unto itself. And you're telling me that isn't how it is anymore?
That's right.
Still waiting on that one. So there we go. That's my analysis of how Star Trek has influenced technology in the modern day world. I hope I've inspired you to actually get into Star Trek. It is pretty amazing. It has special effects, it has fancy uniforms, it has cool spaceships and crazy storylines that make you think. And also the new inventions. Who knows what they're going to feature in a new episode, which could become reality one day. But I'll leave you with this. Put in your comments which Star Trek series you think is my favorite. I've got one favorite, and just pop it in the comments and let's see who wins. So don't forget to like and subscribe.